Back in the Middle Ages, the prevailing European culture was overwhelmingly Catholic. There were people of other faiths, obviously, and certainly people who didn't adhere to the Christian religion, but everything about the world people lived in was Catholic. Not only were churches on every street corner of every city, churches were the anchor of every city. Their bells rang not just for the pleasing sound, but because that's how the city kept track of time. The church and state technically may have been different entities with different leaders, but the worlds were impossible to separate. Everyone knew the liturgical calendar of the church and all of its feasts because that was the calendar. Everyone followed the laws of the church because they were the laws of the land. Is this to say that everyone at this time was deeply religious, taking seriously the call to follow Christ and implement the gospel in their lives? Of course not. Believe it or not, there were bad Christians back then too. People who went to church regularly, even though they didn't believe at all. But even if you were a person of marginal faith at the time, you remained connected to the church because that's what everyone did. The church was simply a part of the cultural structure of people's lives. In the United States, this remained the case until fairly recently. 100 years ago, the church was not simply the place you went on Sunday for worship. It was the primary educator of Catholic children, recreational hall to socialize, and political machine for an area. In many communities, the church was so central to defining one's identity, encapsulating one's faith, culture, language, social life, economics, and politics, that you didn't tell people where you were from, you told people what parish you went to. Even as recently as 1960, just 60 years ago, 75% of Catholics still attended Mass on a weekly basis. 75%. Is this to say that everyone in those days took seriously the call to follow Christ and implement the gospel in their lives? Of course not. Believe it or not, there were bad Christians back then too, people who went to church regularly, even though they didn't believe at all. But even if you were a person of marginal faith at the time, you remained connected to the church because that's what everyone did. The church was simply a part of the cultural structure of people's lives. Today, that cultural structure is disappearing. While there are still places in the country where Christianity remains the dominant social force, where it's assumed that people go to worship on Sundays and public officials blend civil and divine law without much protest, this is hardly the experience of most. Today, religion is largely treated as a private decision of every person. Some people go, some people don't. You can find people who want to worship, who want to live the gospel, who want to be overtly religious, but you can also avoid all of these things if you want. Now, if you're a person of marginal faith, you don't have to remain connected to the church. You're not gonna lose a job opportunity for not having a parish. There are plenty of other places to find a spouse. No one is gonna judge you for spending your Sundays at the beach instead. Simply put, there are fewer social institutions pressuring or guilting someone into doing what they don't want to do. Few people, if anyone at all, goes to church because it's a part of their culture. It's because of this growing reality in our world, the slow erosion of the social forces that kept some people coming, that church attendance has undoubtedly gone down. Now, just 40% of Catholics claim to attend Mass on a weekly basis, a number that is likely higher than the actual reality. It's for this reason that the German theologian Karl Rahner had an insight a few decades ago. Seeing the social structures fade away that had previously kept people of marginal faith coming to the church, he wrote, "The Christian of the future will be a mystic or will not exist at all." The Christian of the future will be a mystic or will not exist at all. What he meant by this is that no one's gonna come to church anymore because they have to. Only those who want to come will come. Only those who are mystics, those who have had a profound experience of the love and forgiveness of God, who are deeply wedded to the mission of Christ and the reign of God, will continue to consider themselves Christian. Because really, what else is gonna keep them here? What else is gonna keep you here? Unless people have a profound experience of Christ that touches them at the very core of who they are, they're gonna find something else to do on Sundays. They're gonna commit their lives to something else. Which, if we accept this to be true, and I think we should, leads us to two very urgent tasks in our day. The first is that we must make our faith as personal as possible. Now, don't misunderstand what I'm saying here. Personal doesn't mean private. It doesn't mean individual. It doesn't mean that I'm on my own and don't care about others. Personal means that our faith moves beyond just truths and concepts and doctrines, but begins to be relational and intimate. I know I've said it before, but it's always worth repeating. no one has ever converted to Christianity because they lost an argument. It doesn't exist up here alone, on the level of knowledge or intellect. Christianity is about personal relationships, with God who loves and heals us in tangible ways, and with each other, companions on the journey for whom we'd be willing to give up our lives. It's not about attending a confirmation class. It's not about a student mass with contemporary music. It's not about youth group and service trips and fun nights. At least not essentially. These things are externals, things that flow from our faith and help give structure to it, but they're not the faith itself. As so many people will soon leave high school for college, college for the real world, these external structures will ultimately disappear. There will come a day when the regular Bible study group is no longer there, when you can't just roll out of bed and have mass in your dorm, when you're not surrounded with 50 others who are going to church because it's the fun place to be. For the rest of us, we live right now in a time of quarantine, a time when we're unable to go to church, unable to be a part of the community, unable to have any of the external aspects of our faith. No one will know if we're remaining a Christian. No one's checking in to see if we're praying, fasting, loving as God intends. When the social structures of our faith fade away, it'll be up to us, the faith within us, to decide if we really want to continue this, to remain a Christian when it's not convenient or fun, when it actually poses a major challenge to our life and society. The only way that this will be possible is if we have regular, personal encounters with God. If we become, as Rahner says, mystics in our day, people who want nothing more than to be in communion with God, which, if this is the case, should fundamentally inform our second task, how we engage in the work of evangelization and catechesis of others. If we accept that the social structures of our church are leaking walls that are about to burst, that in themselves they will soon have no ability to keep people from leaving the church, then it seems to be in our best interest to abandon these structures and focus our attention on what will. Fear and guilt may have kept people coming to Mass years ago, but it ain't gonna work in the future. Lose it. Requiring kids to go to CCD and get certificates of completion before they can receive the sacraments isn't exactly developing lifelong Christians. Burn it to the ground. Trying to make the church hip and fun, following fads and trying to be just like the rest of the world might fill a superficial need for some, but it will never be able to keep up with what is truly hip and fun in our world. Get rid of it. In all of these things, I think we put the cart before the horse. I think we try to set up barriers to prevent people from leaving, pleading with people to stay while giving them no real reason to stay. For me, it's like building a wall around a property, but forgetting to furnish the house. If we want to make disciples of the world, which presumably is the mission of a Christian, then our first, second, and last goal must be to create mystics. It means doing all that we can to facilitate a personal encounter between Christ and the world, to allow our friends, family members, coworkers, parishioners, and everyone we meet to know the loving and healing touch of our God. If that's the only way that people will become and remain Christian, then that has to be the crux of everything we do. More than classes or social events or interest groups, more than telling people what to believe and what the truth is, more than trying to make the parish a fun place or just like the rest of the world. Let the church focus on what it does best, building intimate relationships around an encounter with the living God. This means liturgies that aren't just thrown together at the last minute, but ones with well-rehearsed, theologically sound music that just compels people to sing. It means developing art and symbolism that touches not only the mind, but the heart. It means preaching that doesn't just make people laugh or feel comfortable, but that deeply unsettles them to the reality of the gospel. It means creating an environment of holiness in which people are inspired by one another, who take seriously their call to charity and justice. A place where people are vulnerable with one another, living not by fear but by the light of faith and hope, where prayer is the most important part of their lives and they can't wait to share it with others. It means, at its core, creating a place not just about giving people something to do on Sundays, a way to abate their guilt, but a place where people can have a mystical experience of God and God's people. For me, it doesn't matter how many people our church has or how many people it loses. If this is not the start and end of its mission, then it's not worth having in the first place.